Grace, I'm on page 298 of our textbook. We're getting ready to read a reflective essay called Is Our Gain Also Our Loss? So we're going to talk a little bit about the subgenre of nonfiction called a reflective essay. So first off, a reflective essay is a type of nonfiction in which an author presents his or her thoughts and feelings about an experience or idea. And that may seem kind of like, okay, well, who cares, right? But usually the author, well, you would hope that the author thinks that their feelings about something and their thoughts about something are gonna be beneficial to others, right? And so that's what makes it worth reading. So we can say, the thoughts will benefit others. Others, of course, are the readers. So the author's purpose in a reflective essay is to express insights gained through experience or observation. So insights are kind of like lessons learned, kind of deeper thoughts. So they're not just talking about what happened, but they're talking about the entire experience, right? So not just what they were feeling, but maybe what was motivating them at the time, and kind of reflecting on everything that was happening during that time and not just giving an account of events. So our characteristics for the genre are that we do get descriptions of a specific event, time, period, or person. So notice that we get a description, not just an account. And I'm actually going to say it's not just a list of events. So often they use dialogue and other storytelling elements, so we can see some features of, you know, regular fiction writing. But the dialogue is going to be to share like what others were saying during that time, so we can better understand what the speaker or what the author was experiencing. The language captures the author's process of feeling and thinking. We do have a controlling idea that involves lessons learned or insights gained. And again, these, you know, lessons, these deeper thoughts that they were having. The tone then tends to be thoughtful. The attitude tends to be, you know, this was something worth experiencing and this is kind of the reason why. We do have kind of an emotional quality to the writing as well, because again, we do have the author talking about his or her feelings during the whole thing. So we do have an introduction that provides focus. We have body paragraphs that describe and explain, and a conclusion that summarizes the insight. So the conclusion kind of summarizes for us like why, you know, this was important, what we should have learned from it, what the author learned from it as well. So we're talking about author's purpose and message. In reflective nonfiction, an author's purpose or reason for writing is to reflect on or think deeply about a topic. The writer explores the personal effects or experiences or situations. His or her message is the new insight or sense of truth. This is kind of interesting. Sense of truth gained as a result. To understand the writer's purpose and message in reflective writing, examine all the elements of the text. So you should consider the title, okay, because obviously the author chose it for a reason, and it may give us an idea of what the author's attitude is in a particular topic. Notice the writer's direct statements. So these are statements made directly to the reader. Statements made directly to the reader about the meaning of an experience. These may appear at the beginning of the piece and again at the end in a slightly different way. Look for words and phrases that are emphasized or repeated. Reflective writing is often very direct, and the writer's purpose may be obvious. The author attempts to recreate an experience for the reader and show how it changed his or her understanding. So let's go ahead and, well, at this point, you should go on to the text. I did include a link in step one, so there are actually, I think it's step two, so that you can listen to the text being read as well. And here I want to talk about author's purpose and message. So in a reflective essay, we just talked about how the author's purpose is to examine or to reflect on an aspect or a part of life. The author's message is the insight he or she gains from this reflection, from thinking on it and kind of exploring what or why they may have felt a certain way. The language the author uses fits this purpose and helps express the message. For example, in this essay, the author's diction and use of rhetorical questions reveal her purpose and help express her insight. Well, what is diction? What are rhetorical questions? So diction are the type of words an author chooses. So we already know that there's a ton of different ways that we can express one idea, right? So the diction is just talking about the words that the author chooses to use to express a particular idea. So an author's diction shows how the writer felt, right? It may reveal their attitude, and it shows how he or she thoughts or shows his or her thoughts on an issue. So for example, in the essay, we see the author say, "I waited a moment for his comment to process, then looked down at my phone, analyzing it in a way that I had never before." So notice that she's using words like processing, analyzing. So we can see that this is something that she's putting a lot of thought into. Are rhetorical questions or questions asked for the effect, for effect, or to raise a point rather than to be answered? So in a nutshell, rhetorical questions are kind of questions that are not meant to be answered. It's like when you're hearing a speech made to, you know, 1,000 people and the speaker says something like, "Wouldn't you like to blah blah blah?" Okay, well, they're not expecting for everybody to say like yes or no, right? Those are rhetorical questions meant to get the audience to be thinking about something. So it does tend to pull the reader in, it introduces issues, and it shows questions the author has asked him or herself. So a lot of times these questions might be asked to the audience to kind of let them know the types of questions that the person was asking themselves during that time. So here, this is an example of a rhetorical question. Do we even realize what we're all leaving behind? And of course, it's not meant to be answered, right? It's just meant to be thought-provoking. So anyhow, once you guys finish and we get to the end of the week, I do want you guys to engage in this group discussion through Google Chat. You can find this information on page 307. Before you guys even start engaging in the chat, I do want you to look at this chart at the bottom and think about all the questions that are being asked so that you have like a plan, okay? So that you're not going into the chat room and posting something that seems a little bit rambly and that doesn't make a lot of sense, okay? So you are basically writing a rough draft for the comment that you're gonna be posting, okay? So anyhow, I hope that you guys have a really great week. And if you have any questions, please post it on the chat room, or you can post a comment under any of the assignments. Have a good week.